has an anaphylactic reaction here. First thing you do is get this antibiotic stopped and disconnected from that drip if we can. And then you just get some antibiotic stop breathing, some observations on. Alright.
And disconnect.
Okay, so looking at this area, it does sound like he's got stridor. Looks like there's a bit of swelling there of his tongue and his neck. We've got him nice and flighty now. Okay, lovely, right. Passing my stethoscope, please. Brilliant. So let's have a listen to this chest while we get the stats on and things.
It's okay, Simon. I get you sorted.
So your saturations are only 85%?
Okay, we've got stats of 83 there on us, but we've got some hypoxia, which is brilliant. We'll just pop that up to 10 metres there. Alright, and rest are a bit high as well, counting 40
can
there.
Can I sit up, please? I can't breathe by then.
Okay, we'll sit you up a little bit, Simon, alright? Let's pop that mask on. Alright, so we've got a heart rate of 137. We've got a good blood pressure cuff on for a hint. Do you mind just typing the blood pressure for me as well? Rachel, would you mind giving us some more IV access? We're looking to use this one at the moment, and the antibiotics have been going through it. And Amy, I think we're going to need some adrenaline. So I'll go and work out a dose, and we'll see what we need from that. So Simon weighed 20 kilograms. All right. Let's use these starters. So we've got 20 kilograms here, and we're looking for anaphylaxis. Adrenaline need to be 0.2 mils of running 1,000. We've got 1,000. We'll just drop 2 doses in case we need one for later, and so we can consider a further dose after about 5 minutes or so. So Amy, 0.2 mils of 1 in 10,000 would be great for some adrenaline, and we'll get him some of that and then reassess what he's got with that. So we're starting A with the adrenaline, we've got some oxygen for B. C will probably benefit from some fluids, Rachel. We could just get a bolus based on his weight of 20 kilograms. And looking at D, you alright, Simon? How are you feeling? Oh. You can't breathe. Well, we're making you better. This oxygen is going to make you breathe a little bit better. Let's have a look in those eyes. Just going to lift those eyelids up, check your pupils. Brilliant. So we'll do some adrenaline just into the side of his thigh. A little injection coming here, Simon, into the side of your thigh, alright? It'll be a little bit nitty, but it's going to make you feel better. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we've had that adrenaline, we've got his oxygen, we're getting some fluids.
Yeah.
From the top and see how we're doing. Alright, Simon, how are things now? So that stridor sounds like we're a little bit better than we were before. Simon's gone down a wee tiny bit. Let's have a listen to this. Oh, good. I'm glad things are a bit easier for you. Let's listen to these lungs. Yeah, it sounds very wheezy. We've got a fluid roll, so that's what's fine. A nebulizer, please. Very easy there. I think it's possibly worse than before, actually. It doesn't seem like we've had much improvement there.
So I think it's got a bit of reflection as well.
So I think a nebulizer would be great. He's got a bit of recession, so B doesn't look like it's improved too much. So as well as that nebulizer, I think a second lot of adrenaline, Rachel, after you've had that fluid roll, this would be brilliant. Thanks.
Where's my mum?
Your mum's just gone home to get you some comfy clothes, get you pyjamas. She'll be back soon, don't you worry. But you're here with me, Rachel and Amy.
Okay.
So now we're under pressure. Can I keep the blood pressure for us? Yeah. Let's just have that fluid. And we'll repeat that blood pressure. Heart rate is really good. That's good.
Second adrenaline.
Second adrenaline, that's brilliant. We'll go on that other side this time. There we go, Simon. big massage, lovely. Alright, so we've had our second dose of adrenaline, we've got a nebulizer going. I think Simon's going to need some time on the intensive care ward of paediatrics, so I'm going to give them a ring if that's okay.
Yep.
Any problems, just give us a quick call, we'll use this phone.
Yeah. Okay,
hello, it's just Beth, one of the ED regs. I've got a wee boy, a 5-year-old and 8 at the moment. So I'm concerned it's having an anaphylaxis reaction. I'm just thinking it's going to need some time on PICU. It's come in to hospital today with a preoperative cellulitis and was getting antibiotics through an IV drip. After about 10 minutes, started to develop some stridor. He's so far had 2 doses of adrenaline for his weight. He's had salbutamol now. He's picked up a little bit from a stridor point of view, but his chest is still quite wheezy and he's still got SAPs of around 85% and that's on high flow oxygen. So I'm just thinking he might need possibly some airway input from yourselves, but definitely a period of time on the PICU. No. Brilliant. Thanks very much.
Bye.
Okay, so the consultants are going to come down from PICU to have a look at him. Could you get some blood collection, bits and bobs together just to take some levels? It sounds like it was the first reaction to that antibiotic, I didn't know.
Okay.
Didn't know about it beforehand. So it was very easy before, what are we doing now? Certainly much better after that salbutamol. Okay, I noticed his SATs have picked up as well. We've still got a bit of a low blood pressure and high heart rate, but hopefully with the fluid and some time, that will improve as well. It seems like generally things have got a bit better, so a couple of other things we need to consider with him will be some chlorphenamine, some antihistamine for him, and also some hydrocortisone and some steroids.
Okay.
So I'll look at those doses. There was no immediate need for them, but I think now we're a bit more stable, we can focus on improving the rest of his symptoms as well.
What happened?
Yeah.